Wonderful band, Susie. Thanks very much to them for being here today. And also to you guys for tuning in. Ola and I are going to talk about food today, my absolutely favorite topic. I like it so much, I even got Debby to cook for me outside the studio.
You did?
Yeah, so we will switch outside sometimes to see what she's up to. I'm really excited for today.
Equally here. Michelle, you know we're not just talking about food today.
We're not?
No, we're not. Curious sports is what we're going to be talking about. Michelle, you remember that last time I saw you in high heels?
Yes.
With that fashionable handbag? Eating cheese?
Yeah, probably.
The combination of those three items are going to feature prominently in our next segment.
Ooh, I'm excited.
Let's take a look.
What to have? cheese, handbags and perms in common?
I really don't know. So, I mean, I like cheese and I like shoes, but I don't know.
What if I tell you that they are sports?
Really? So, I mean, let's try it out. So now we changed and I would say, let's try it out.
Ready, set, go.
So congratulations for winning the race, and would you maybe do this for one day as a professional?
Well, I think it's an interesting sport, but my knees are hurting, so I wouldn't do this as a professional.
Yeah, same to me, and I would say let's try out the next one.
Yeah, sure. Our next sport is throwing handbags.
Nice, are there some rules in it?
Well, a handbag shouldn't weigh more than 10% of your own weight. And you can throw it freestyle or like a disc or as you like.
Okay, that sounds good. So I really want to try it out.
That's nice. I have one handbag for you. Congrats on winning our second task.
Thank you.
How does it feel to throw your handbag?
Yeah, it was funny. So normally I wouldn't throw my bags away. And yeah, it was great. And now I'm really excited what's going on.
Now we are going to chase a cheese downhill. So we're here at the Ehrenberg. We're going to try this 200 years old tradition here because we don't have a hill like them in Scotland.
Yeah, I also brought a cheese, as you see, but I don't think that it's 200 years old, so, but I think it will be fun.
Yeah, it's okay. It doesn't have to be 200 years old, but I have a surprise for you. We have another guest, Chrissy. She's a cheese lover.
I really think it's going to be fun running down the hill chasing cheese.
Okay, then let's do this, ladies. It seems like everybody has won a challenge, so we're all winners, and we're going to celebrate that.
So it really was really much fun. I've never chased a cheese down the hill.
No, me neither, but I almost got it, so yeah, it was really, really nice.
Yeah. Oh.
Well, wow, they really deserve that ring in
they
the
do,
end.
They do, indeed, they do. Michelle, I, as gorgeous as you looked in those high heels, I just can't imagine you running down, you know, the tracks in an Olympic game, you know, event or something.
It just hurt from looking at us. So
it does, indeed.
I don't want to try that.
The strange things women do.
So, Ola, what's up next?
We're talking about communication next.
Oh.
Imagine this, Michelle. We all talk. Are we all really communicating?
Sometimes, probably.
Our next segment is about an interview done by Stein Brein on how to communicate. Take a listen.
Well, the job is to recruit participants from a conflict area and then to build enough trust so that participants have the courage to talk, share their stories, their emotions, their feelings, because otherwise it will just be some kind of a debate. And in a debate, people share their positions, but there is hardly any movement toward each other. And when you have a debate on television, you talk to those who already agree with you. So dialogue is a way of communicating where there is possibility for bridge building in terms of how people understand the world. And I think a lot of conflicts is rooted in the fact that people don't understand that other people see the world very differently. So dialogue is that process where you learn more about how other people see the same world as you. The most fascinating part of my job is to see in people's faces that this light bulb goes on. Wow, now I understand. And I'll give an example. It's a brutal example. There is in Kosovo, there is an accusation that school children were poisoned in 1991, I think. And if you go to Kosovo today and you ask Serbs, did it happen? They will say no, because it's the Serb authorities that are accused of this. Come on, of course it didn't happen. If the person is an Albanian, they will say, yes, of course, I was there. And both believe there is only one truth, the other part is lying. Then when we were sitting and talking about this, one Serb is saying, you really believe we poisoned you? Now I understand why you hate us. Because up to that point, he was certain they were lying. So when he realized they really believe it, then things started to make sense. Then I understand why you don't respect us. I would like to see dialogue recognized for what it is. Even today, somebody, you know, asks questions like dialogue is something soft, it's something mild. I think a dialogue can be more truthful and more honest, and this image of dialogue as cozy, as nice talk, is completely opposite of what I have experienced. I mean, people are telling about how their brother were shot, how their house were burned down, you know, what they felt when the guerrilla came into the village. These are brutal, brutal realities. And if dialogue is recognized as an important part of peace building, I think peace building would be much more successful. Today, we're spending a lot of money going into peace building, but there is very little peace coming up. Aha. I think that my message is very clear, and I think I said it today. Don't expect changing the world to be a summer job. Changing the world is almost like a lifetime commitment. And if you expect too much, too soon, too fast, you will be discouraged and you will give up. If you realize that even small things contribute to a change in the bigger picture, when a lot of students think like you, then you're part of a movement which is much, much bigger. But dialogue is no magic fix. This is a lifelong struggle.
So this was really informative. I didn't know that dialogue was that important to our world. But I also want to talk about my next topic. So I want to see what Debby is up to right now in the kitchen.
So, hey guys, we're going to cook churros today. It's an Iberian dish. I have a little helper here with me, Yannick. Say hi. Oh, he can't say hi because he doesn't have a microphone. Whoops. My bad, because it's more important to hear what I have for instructions for him. So we're going to first start with the coating of the churros. For that, we need sugar and cinnamon. So we'll make it really cinnamony, because I really like cinnamon. So I already measured the sugar. So we need, if you want to make this at home yourself, you need 1 cup of sugar. So Yannick is going to put the sugar onto the baking sheet. And then just put it all over so that it's nice and even. And I'll measure the cinnamon. Let's have a look. So you need 1.5 teaspoons cinnamon. Teaspoons, if you don't know, it's these little cups. You can buy them online or in stores. So I love cinnamon, like who doesn't love cinnamon? And then we'll just do this. And this, put the half. Okay, Yannick, you're just going to take the whisk over there, and you're just going to do your thing. So our next step is to heat the stove, have a big pot, a large pot, and now we're going to add 2 cups of water first. 2 cups of water are also 500 milliliters. So let's put that in here. So turn up your stove quite high. It needs to boil a bit as well. And we're going to measure the butter. Please don't forget to also cube your butter, because otherwise it'll be clumpy and everything. And yeah, you don't want clumpy batter. Who wants that? So I'm going to measure 1/2 cup. I already put it into cubes to make it a bit more easier to put it into the cup here. Oh, that looks good, Yannick. You don't need to continue now. Thank you very much. So 1/2 cup of butter. Let's look at this. That's not 1/2 cup yet. And always like have a knife, because then you can like, you know, make a clear edge on top. That looks good, doesn't it? Nicely. So I'm going to cube this into the water. I'm going to use a spatula. It's quite helpful. There we go. I know it's a bit weird to put everything into cups, because then you make all the cups dirty and everything. And I'm also more a fan of the metric system, but the recipe called for cups. And yes, the recipe will be online after the show, also with metric numbers, because who uses cups? Oh, right, I do. So we got that in there. Now I already see it's melting in there, very nice. And then we're going to add 2 tablespoons of sugar. So this is a tablespoon. And then we're going to add, oh, well, that's a bit clumpy. 2 tablespoons of sugar, 1 and 2. There we go. Easy enough. So now we're going to let this boil a bit, get warm, so that the butter dissolves entirely. Therefore, I'm going to ask Yannick for the whisk. Yannick, may I please have the whisk? Well, thank you very much. I'm sorry. I'm in the studio right here, and there are people right next to me, and they're all laughing. Okay, so the butter is dissolving quite nicely. I see it, yes, a bit steam coming up. That's completely natural. No worries, I'm not gonna burn down the building. I'm sorry. Okay, so there we go. Now it's almost completely dissolved. I see a bit of butter still. Want it nice. Okay, that looks good to me. So our next part is that we're going to add a bit of salt. Where's my salt? 1/2 teaspoon salt. Be careful about the salt. You don't want to overindulge on it. Now that looks good. Okay, perfect. I'm just going to stir it a bit as well. I'm gonna turn down the heat a bit, because we're going to add flour now. And for the flour, we need medium heat. So our next step is adding flour, as I already said. Oh, this is the flour. Oh, I could have asked for it, Yannick, but I'm just way too into this cooking. I just love cooking, and you know, sometimes you're just in my way. I already hear it boiling very nicely. So 2 cups, this is a cup. I accidentally broke it off, so oh well, happens. adding the flour here. It's okay if your dough is a bit lumpy. That's completely okay because we're going to beat it anyways after it has rested. But before we get to that part, we first have to add the flour. Okay, it's boiling now. Let me turn it down. Looks good. Okay, one cup. And now I need a second cup. Whoops. Completely okay making a mess. I don't have to clean it up. Huh. Well, probably have to clean it up. So churros, why am I making churros? Well, first of all, because it's a great dish, why not? It tastes amazing. And churros are also well known in South America and Middle America. And it's just a great dish. You can have it anytime as a snack or something. Yannick, please hand me the wooden spoon. Where's the wooden spoon? Oh, it's right over here. Oh, I found it myself. Thank you very much. So let's just have that there. Can I hand you the spoon? Thank you very much. Okay, so I'm going to turn it down a bit more because it's boiling a bit too much for me. As I said, it's okay if it has clumps, but it has to become a dough. Like, it can't be completely liquid because that's not the meaning of making a dough. So, oh well. So we see big clumps here, but I just have to stir constantly, stirring, and then it will become a nice dough. Yeah, there's nothing else exciting going to happen in the next few seconds. So I think it's most sinful. No, not sinful. I'm sorry, my Denglish. It makes sense to go back into the studio to Michelle and Ola. But just a short notice, after I finish the dough here, I need to rest it at least 5 minutes because we have to beat an eggs at the next part. And you don't want to scramble your eggs in hot dough because that doesn't make sense. Like, who does that? Okay, so this is looking good. I'm just gonna keep stirring on, and back to you, Michelle and Ola.
Thank you, Debby. It looks really fun outside. I wish I was there too, but I really hope she does not burn down the building.
Yeah.
So, Ola, did you ever eat churros before?
No. I'm curious to actually have, my taste bud is actually curious to taste it.
So I am too. I am also curious. So while we wait for the dough to stir, we can just listen to another song from Susie.
I was just guessing at numbers and figures. pieces, pulling your puzzles apart. Questions of science, science and progress, do not speak as loud as my heart. Tell me you love me, come back and haunt me. Oh, when I rush to the start, running in circles, chasing our tails, coming back as we are. Nobody said it was easy. Oh, it's such a shame for us to part. Heart. I'm going back to the start.
Michelle.
Yeah.
That was lovely.
Yeah, it was.
When is ISWIsion again?
I think in about a year.
Let's send them there.
Definitely. Maybe we then finally have a chance of winning.
They did a great job. That was a wonderful, you know, tune.
Yeah. So maybe in the meanwhile, Debbie's a bit further with her cooking. Let's just switch over to her.
Yes, do that.
So yes, I am a bit further. But I've got a little teensy problem. I haven't had enough time to get my dough cooled off properly because, you know, it was quite hot on the stove. So I sent out my helper, Yannick. He is helping me cooling off the dough because it really needs to be cool, because otherwise I'm going to bake eggs in a dough. That's weird, isn't it? Well, I think it's weird, but I can already put my mixer. So we're going to mix the eggs into the dough. So I'll just attach it here. I'm sorry that I disappeared for a moment. I'm back. Hope you didn't miss me. So as I said, next part is cracking eggs into our dough. But first we have to check if our eggs are even good. Always do that because you never know if you have a rotten egg. So just crack it open, check it, smells fine, then get another egg, and let's crack it open into an already used cup, and we'll put that in there, smell it, smells fine, so, and then I'm going to add a teaspoon of vanilla to my eggs. So get some vanilla extract. It's always great in everything that you bake. 1 teaspoon, so I don't have 1 teaspoon, but easy enough, I take 2 half teaspoons. So we'll put that in. 1, there we go. Let's just put in a bit more. Okay, so now I'm going to call my assistant and ask him if the dough has cooled down. Yannick, has the dough cooled down? Oh, well, he's coming in. Let's see if the dough has cooled down. Welcome back, Yannick. Great seeing you. So thank you for bringing me the dough. Has it cooled down? He doesn't know. Well, it's still a bit hot. Let me just have a look here. Well, I think we can maybe put it in. Let's start putting the stuff in. So we'll add the eggs and the vanilla now. see that everything comes out. And don't forget, if you used your any spatula, spoons, and that gets into contact with egg, don't use it with anything else because you might get salmonella. And we don't want people to get sick. So now we're just gonna beat it here. Beat it, beat it. It's okay, it looks quite clumpy-ish now. I know it has weird consistency, but it will come together. You just have to beat it long enough. It's going to be quite a sticky dough. We already see it's climbing up, oops, climbing up the beaters. That's why I can't really show it because I'm too scared that I'm going to make a mess. Whoops, that fell down. Yanni, could you please put that onto my shoulder? Oh, well, thank you. He's such a nice person. He's so useful, right? Okay, we see the dough is coming together, but I'm not really happy with it yet. Just gonna beat it more. So what else can I say about churros? Oh, what can you have for dips with churros? Anything. I once made a chocolate dip with it. It was really yummy. Or you can like put sprinkles onto them, cinnamon and sugar, or jam, peanut butter, anything you want. I think you can also eat churros maybe savory. I don't really know it. I wouldn't do that because I somehow connect churros with dessert. This looks good. I think we're finished. And then we're going to put that down. Janne, can you please unplug the beater? So if you already have a helper, why should he do the dirty work? I'm sorry. Okay. So just get everything off the beater. It's a bit difficult. And don't lick the beater. I know temptation is quite big. Do it myself, but not here. That would be unhygienic. Okay, so we're going to now, well, come on, get off. There we go. We're going to, Janne, could you please now move all of these things away? Wait a second, I need to give you this as well. So while Janne is putting everything away, I'm going to heat my pan, get a deep pan or bowl or anything. It needs to be deep, so you can put around 4 centimeters, 3 to 4 centimeters in there. For non-metric people, that's like 2 inches, but we're metric people, so let's go for it. So we're gonna fry the churros. I'm going to put the churros into a bag and then squeeze them out. And then I'll put them onto the paper towels, and then Yannick has to put the churros from the paper towels into the sugar coating, sugar cinnamon coating, and then he'll put them onto the wooden board. Sorry, the English word ran away from me. Okay, that's looking good. I'm not really gonna do 4 centimeters, it's just too much, in my opinion. But you already see I've almost used an entire bottle. But I think that's completely enough. If you have a sugar candy thermometer, that could help you with deciding how hot it's going to be. Like it needs to cook a bit, boil a bit, but not really steam boil. Yeah, so I'll just add a bit more. Don't worry, I'm not going to burn down this building. Here, Yannick. Then we'll put the, got something in my face. Put that over there, that over there. Okay, Yannick, you know what your job is now? No, I just explained it. So I'm going to add the dough into here, then get a bit larger opening on the bottom, so that you can have wide churros. The oil isn't cooking yet. It's warm enough, in my opinion. So I'm just gonna fill the Can you please put this to the side, Yannick? I asked you, and you didn't do it. Like, get a good helper. Like, seriously, he should listen to you. If you already give him orders, like, I pay him with food. So, shouldn't that be enough for him? Like, seriously, come on. Okay, let me just put that down there. You can put a bit more than this into the bag because this will maybe make one or two churros, and we want to make a bit more. I'm still going to put some in here. I normally have a reusable bag, but that one broke the last time when I made churros, so I had to get some other bags. Let me just put a bit more in. And if you're close by the EAZ, you can stop by and try one if you'd like to. I'd be happy to give you one. Better said, Yannick would be happy to give you one. I'm just too busy cooking. It's getting warmer. I don't want to put it in yet. So, we're just going to talk a bit about what else we've been up to today. So preparation for this dessert, it doesn't take long. You really just need water, butter. Please, Yannick, stay professional. So you need water, butter, sugar, salt, flour, eggs, vanilla, and cinnamon. That's it. It's simple and easy. Like, when I saw churros for the first time, I was like, oh my gosh, that looks so difficult. But it's actually not difficult. Yannick, could you please put my watch somewhere safe where the oil won't damage it? Thank you very much. Oh, such a kind helper. I pay him well with food. So, it's getting warmer a bit. Let's try it just for the heck of it. I'm going to put the first one in. It's a bit difficult. Oh, that was, shoot. And it popped everywhere. Oh, well, that wasn't the plan. That happens when you cook live. Yannick, I need to save up, please. Thank you. We're just gonna go with the groove. Like, I could have prepared. My mom told me, try it out first with those bags. You don't know if they're going to work. And now I know they really don't work. Thank you, Mom. Shoot. This is really not working. I really, dang. I probably put too much in there. This is a complete mess. I'm going to give back to Michelle and Ola because I need some time. Bye.
So.
And the very funny award goes to, she's the best funny chef I've ever had.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, you really want to go outside there.
Hello, I'm Professor Dr. Koch, and today we're doing the main dish, which is jollof rice, also called Bennigen. We're doing a German vegetarian version with vegetables that you can get in Germany, like tomatoes, carrots, sweet potatoes, and vegetable broth. And we normally you can also eat this with meat, but we're not doing this today. And the first steps are washing the rice, and cutting everything into pieces, which I will be doing now. So for this, I just put everything besides. And start, how do you call it? Making the carrot naked?
There, when's dinner ready?
Almost. I finished cutting all of this vegetables alone.
So what are you doing next?
I'm putting them into the pan, okay. Except for the tomatoes and the chili, which will be later. And
Well, I'm excited.
Put everything in. And while we're doing this, we also, while all of this is frying, we're doing some vegetable broth. Because we need it later for the rice. The only thing I'm kind of missing is something to mix it in the pan. But that's probably something on the side. You actually just wait till this is like fried a little bit. So now we're adding the tomato paste, which has to be in with the vegetables in the pan for about 5 minutes until we can add the rice. The vegetables have now been frying for a bit, so we're adding the rice and also fry it for a bit and before adding the vegetable broth to make it a bit like a risotto so that the rice can take in all of the broth. Yeah. So that's what we're going to do now. And mix it very good so that it can also like be one with the vegetables. Yeah. And now we have to wait till it's a little bit clear and not that white anymore. Okay, so the rice is now a little bit clearer so we can add the tomatoes and also the broth so that the rice can soak it in. Just go in here. Oh. And mix it a little bit, and then a little bit of broth. And we're gonna just add a lot of broth all the time so that the rice can slowly take it in. And if you don't have any broth anymore, we just take water. So,
Michelle, you finished already?
Not yet. Okay. It takes a while because we have to wait again till it's fried. I'm sorry. Yeah. All alone in the kitchen. Ah, seems like the rice is almost finished, so we can like start adding the spices. For example, like chili and thymian. Luckily, we have these great boards. Which you can flip, and you have to shake. Okay, that's not working. So, like this. Always look where the camera is. And then, of course, some salt, because you always need salt, especially if you are salty. Oh, that must be not too much. I hope this is salt. Please don't tell me it's sugar. So, a little bit of pepper. I hope this is called pepper. Because there's also like pepper ball, no, ball pepper, which is paprika. That's not the same. Because this is paprika powder. And now we can call Chrissy. Chrissy? Hi, Chrissy, there you are.
Is it ready?
Yeah, it's ready. I'm gonna give you something. It's a little bit clumpy, but it's supposed to be. It's like risotto.
Okay, so, okay, it looks really nice.
Tell me how you feel about it.
Mmm, interesting, but really, really great. I love it. Oh my god. I'll take this with me.
Okay.
Thank you. This is so great. I love it.
Thank you. Bye.
Bye.
Michelle, you can cook.
Yeah, as you can see, I also tried my hand on it.
Yeah, but I saw that was like a dish from Africa, I think.
Yeah, traditional African.
Wow. I've learned so much from you, Michelle, and then you are still teaching me about my own origin. That is...
I did try like a more unique recipe because you can change it up very much. That's what it's all about, this is we like changing traditions, trying new stuff. So
wow. I bet that was a lot of work.
Well, it was. Also, I did like had a lot of problems with the rice. I kind of spilled it everywhere. So that's why there's not much of it.
I think it's a little bit debatable now. We need who's going to win the Funny Chef Award between yourself and Debbie?
Well, I personally didn't have a Yannick, so I guess it's kind of clear who's winning.
We'll put that to our viewers. I'm sure they can, you know, they can vote on it.
But just another question, like for the viewer, what do you think is like going on tomorrow during ISWI?
That's a wonderful question. That brings us to our next section, which is the PTV news. And in the news, basically, we will be having a guest speaker or a, sort of like a panel of discussion on integration and participation of refugees and migrants at 7 p.m. at the Audimax tomorrow. And the entrance fee is free. So just go there and then you can be part of that. And then if you've got itchy feet and eager to sing, the clubs are open tonight. BC Club, you have Craft Beer Night. BD, you have ISWI Klug Scheisten. BH, Fiesta de la Montana. And BI, you have the karaoke. That's what we have for the news right now.
Well, that sounds like a lot to do. Yeah. But like, do you smell that?
I think I can, actually.
So like, I think Debbie might have like found an idea to do it. I have no idea. But we can like maybe look at her.
Let's find out. Let's go.
And other helpers around here who are actually just viewers. We put three bags now together and it's working better. I just need to heat the oil a bit up more. I was a bit worried that it would be too hot and that it would like explode. So now we have it a bit warmer. I've put more in now. It's gonna take more time. I'm not finished yet. I haven't even put something into the sugar cinnamon coating. So what have I learned from this experience? Listen to your mom. Mom knows best. And I know, Mom, if you're watching this, you were right. It hurts saying, I know. So I'm gonna put in a bit more again. Let's just get that. Okay, let's see. That one's not through yet. Well, I've got a little, a very little one, as you see here. I'm gonna put that on here and put it there. That's now your job. And he's going to coat it in sugar and cinnamon. I'm sorry that it's only that little. I'm really sorry. This was unexpected that this wouldn't work properly. I know I should have tried it. So yeah, we're just going to let this simmer a bit more. The oil is not hot enough really. It needs to warm up a bit more. But the first little piece can be tasted. So I'm going to ask Michelle and Ola to join us. Yannick, if you could please go to the side over there. Thank you. And you two, please join me on this side.
Smells good.
Nice.
Yeah, so you can try that little piece.
Do you want to try it? You never had one before.
Lady first.
Well, it's only one, so.
I don't know, like, I'm being a gentleman right now, so you go ahead.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
So.
Go for it.
Can I? Okay.
How was that?
Very sugary.
Better watch my...
Better watch the diet.
Yeah, for diabetes and all.
Does it get a 5 on diabetes?
Oh, well.
Probably. But I still love it. Thank you so much for cooking today for us.
Yeah, well, I hope that I'll finish this evening. I should finish this. And then we'll put some pictures up later, and then you can look at them, how they should look in the end. And then, of course, we're going to take some pictures of the finished ones, proper finished ones, and upload them onto our social media accounts. Yeah.
So for our parting shot, we will be going back to Susie. We hope our viewers do enjoy this last piece as we stay back and enjoy Debbie's churros. Thank you very much. Oh.
can't stop staring at those ocean eyes, burning cities and napalm skies. 15 flares inside those ocean eyes, your ocean eyes, no fear. You really know to make me cry when you give me those ocean eyes. I'm scared. I've never fallen from quite this high, falling into your ocean eyes, those ocean. I've been walking through a world gone blind, can't stop thinking of your diamond mind. Careful creature made friends with time, he left her lonely with a diamond mind. And those ocean eyes, no high, falling into your ocean eyes, those ocean eyes.